What's going on, guys? AD here. Hope you're having a great day. I've got something really special. This is Battle Brothers. This is a game that just came out of Early Access recently, and it's a lot of fun. It's a very brutal and challenging game. It's kind of on par with Darkest Dungeon, especially on the harder difficulty levels. And I thought it'd be a lot of fun to start off on like a veteran, do a veteran Iron Man play, and then maybe an expert Iron Man play, and see how far we get, and see how we can make our mercenary company grow. And that's really the end goal of this game. Is you start off with a mercenary company and your mission is to grow the company, get better contracts, and become well known throughout the land. And meanwhile, while you're doing all that, there's all these other factions. There's some noble houses that can war each other. There's orcs that can invade. There's undead. And there's also goblins and quite a few other things like vampires and stuff like that. So there's it's a low fantasy setting game. A lot of fun. And I think it's really a cool game. So I think you'll have fun watching along and following along with this game. Let's go ahead and start off with a new campaign. And let's see here. So we can name our company. But first I'm going to choose a flag for our company. And let's see, they got quite a few different options here, but I'm gonna go with this one. This one here, I like this design. It's pretty cool. Company name, I guess we'll call it the Red Claws. All right, and we're gonna start off on veteran, and of course we're gonna do Iron Man. And so there's these late game crises that can happen. A war between the noble houses, greenskin invasion, so orc invasion, or undead scourge. And there's also a permanent destruction. So if you want to have kind of like a limited sandbox experience, because eventually towns will get overrun and get destroyed, then you can leave permanent destruction on. I'm going to turn this off so that we can continue playing for however long we want, or until we lose, basically. And map seed is pretty cool, because if you want to share a map with your friends, you can do that just by entering in the map seed. Really cool. These two options, the permanent destruction checkbox and map seed, have just been added recently, and the developers really listened to their fans, so it's really cool. Props to them, because this was this permanent destruction issue was a big thing on the forums for those that wanted to play the game for as long as they wanted without losing towns and stuff like that. So really good props to them. All right, let's go ahead and start the game and see what happens. The last battle, it all went wrong 2 days ago. The company was hired to track down Hoggart the Weasel and his band of raiders. It was them who found you first, an ambush. All right, so our mercenary company has been ambushed by Hoggart the Weasel. And we just lost one of our guys. And here's our Captain Bernhard. But Captain Bernhard gets killed. And Hoggart the Weasel is on his way out the door. He's leaving his men to do the to clean up the mess. All right, we've got this guy named Gunther. Let's see if we can take this guy out. Ooh, good hit. All right, we'll move Hans in. Nice hit. Torleif. Oh, Torleif misses. Ooh, bold move. That thug went right to our crossbowman. He's got a knife on him. Damn, I thought I could hit him with the bow there. Alright, we gotta take this guy out quick. Ooh. Come on, we gotta get to him. Already we're getting our asses kicked. All right, let's see. Oh, crushing hit. Oh my goodness, Gunther is almost dead. Oh, wow. We almost lost that. Almost lost the guy. No loot? What the hell? Well, that sucks. That's a first, actually, to get no loot out of this game. All right. Well, we got no loot from them. All right, we are alive. Bernhard's dead. They slit his throat. He was a good man and a damn good leader, but it all it took was one mistake. That makes you in charge now, don't it? Alright, so now we need to head back to the town of Kallenberg here and talk to the guy that hired us. Let's just take a look at this map here. This is actually not bad. However, this is actually... Look at this. We've got one faction that has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8... 8... wow, 8 cities they own. So this house, Eisenstein, is huge. That's amazing. Wow. So I guess we're going to be doing a lot of stuff for them. All right, anyway. Let's come back here, and let's go back to Kallenberg. They've got a iron vein. Okay. Harold the Younger sits beside you and asks if you took care of Hoggart. We killed his men, but the weasel eluded our blades in the end. You did well, Sellsword. The brigands have been removed, though it's a shame that Hoggart still lives. Alright, so we get 400 crowns for this, but he's going to ask us for our services one more time, and he wants us to hunt down Hoggart the Weasel. So, of course, yeah, we're going to take this. We have unfinished business with him, and... that's what we're going to do. We're going to go after him. And we need more men, though. That's the problem. So we need to actually go out and hire on some more people into a mercenary company. So here in Kallenberg, we've got an armorer. Let's take a look. Got some wooden shields here for 114. That's not bad, but I was hoping they'd be a little bit cheaper. Padded leather for 253. I'm totally going to get that. And we need shields, so I'm going to buy these shields. Alright, so we got shields. I probably should have checked the market first. See, there was a shield for 91. Let's see, what else we have? Alright, we got a bludgeon for 61. Tools and supplies for 202. That's perfect. We really need that. I guess we'll have to go with bludgeons for now. Oh, we got a pitchfork. Pitchfork isn't bad, but... Hold on, let me see if we can hire on some people, because that's what we need to do, first of all. We honestly do not have any good choices here. So we're going to have to go... We got to go over here to Grafenwasser. Let's take a look. A collection of many smaller settlements spread throughout the dry spots in the swampy area. Alright, never been to Grafenwasser before, but it looks like everybody wants to go to the tavern and have a pint. Get their spirits up. Okay, sure. Why not? They do have a tavern, so let's do that. Here we go. Your men cheer and toast to riches and a long life. Alright, so we've got a Fletcher in this town. We've got a temple. A ton of people we can hire, which is really good. Let's take a look. We've got a flagellant. A peddler for 120. A brawler for 150. What is this guy? A rat catcher? I think we'll take him for 110. This guy's a eunuch. We'll take the Daytaler. Ooh, a cultist. Yeah, we're going to take him. And a servant. Servants are often not used to hard physical labor. Yeah, probably don't want him. Sometimes you can read the description of each of the men, and sometimes they'll tell you if they're going to be sort of decent or not. But servants usually, I don't think, are going to be very good. Let's see, a eunuch. I don't know. Caravan hand is nice, but we can't afford that. Peddler, flagellant. No, we can't do that. How many? We got six. We need one more, I think. Let's take the, eunuch, I guess. Alright, what do we have here? Alright, this guy here has two stars in his range skill. Oh, this guy's shit. Wow. That guy is not very good. This guy, let's see, he's Iron Jaw. Okay, so let's see, Hans, one of our main companions, has Sure Footing and Spartan, so that's actually not bad. Plus 5 melee defense. This guy here is Cocky and Determined. So, I'm not really liking that Cocky. That's pretty bad, because he's got negative 5 melee defense and range defense. But we might make him a... I don't know. We might have to make him some sort of shield user or something like that. We're going to get rid of the two-hander weapon anyway. And let's see. Yeah, here we go. The eunuch is dexterous, which gives him plus 5 melee. Yeah, damn. Look at that. When Ewald was just a boy, a local clergyman castrated him so his voice could carry a higher pitch in the local choir. Oh, shit. Ouch. Alright, that sucks. Okay, so we got enough of that. We need to go to the marketplace and, okay, here's a shield. We already have two shields. We need some weapons. So we've got 959. Let's take this axe and... I guess we'll have to take the bludgeon, 110. I really like axes, or hatchets. They do pretty well. Let's see, what can we outfit our guys with just enough stuff? Alright. We still need a couple more shields for our guys. We still need three shields and a weapon. Alright, let's get some shields then. I guess a buckler will have to do. I'm gonna take this helmet too. Having just a hat is good, is better than having no hat. Gambeson, oh, 183, that's not bad. Take that. Alright, 135, we're kind of... we have no cash. This Fangshire Helm is actually a... because I bought the Supporter Edition, you get this and at the start of every game. And this gives you... allows a wearer to see at night and negates any penalties due to nighttime. So we can give this to our Archer, which... Where the hell is our Archer? Do we even have one? Yeah, we do. Here we go. Gunther. Alright, get rid of this then. Totally forgot he was our archer. Alright, let's move him there. There we go. Okay. Alright, who's got the best melee skill? I want to keep... Oh, we got to keep our cultists alive, because they are really handy to have later on. There's some special stuff that can happen with the cultist. Let's see. We need somebody to have... There we go. Alright, yeah, that's not bad. Alright, we'll give this guy a buckler. Okay, good enough for now. Give that guy a shield. And give this, yeah, give him a shield. There we go, perfect. Alright, I think we got enough men here. We just gotta, it takes a minute to figure everything out. Alright, let's head back to Kallenberg now. And now that we have enough men, we should be able to find Hoggart the Weasel. We're paying about 57 crowns per day, so we got 2 days left to find him and kill him. Alright, so we gotta find Hoggart. Where is he? There he is. He's in the abandoned homestead, so let's go down here. See if we can take him out. Nighttime, yeah, let's go ahead at nighttime. We've got a brigand, a few brigand thugs and a brigand poacher. Alright, so our archer should be able to hit them no matter what. We're going to move in a little bit here. Oh, there he is right there. Alright, these guys with the knives are not really going to do much damage, I don't think, but whatever, we're going to get them up there. Alright, 55% chance to hit. Let's go for it. Oh! Killed him in one hit. Nice. Must have hit him right in the head. Alright, let's get everybody up here. And we're going to go shield wall with as many people as we can. Shield wall kind of increases our defenses here a little bit. Let's take a look. Puncture, knockback. I'm just going to wait. I'm going to see what Hoggart does. Okay, so he's going to move in. Alright, let's take out the guy with no armor, since Hoggart has a lot of armor, and look at that. 26% chance to hit, and a 58. So let's go with the 58. Do some damage to this guy. As much as we can. Now, the cool thing is if you get your archer behind the line of defense, or your front line, you can then shoot through them and hit somebody. Oh, nice. Nicely done. We're getting really lucky here with the hits. Oh, miss, miss. What is going on here? Oh my goodness, come on. Shit. I should probably get my archer back. I forgot he has low health. Nice. Okay, we got him down. Let's go ahead and surround Hoggart now. And we've got... The cool thing about hatches is that... Or axes in general is that you can use a skill called Split Shield, which will get rid of his shield. Takes up a lot of fatigue. But... Oh, shit. I gotta get my archer out of there. He's about to get killed. There we go. Alright, we don't have to worry about that. I can leave my archer where he is. This guy should be able to... Hopefully the eunuch can take him out. Alright, so what he's done is use riposte. So he's going to swing anytime we try to attack him. I'm not going to attack him yet. I'm actually going to just enable... Let's just see if we can take out the archer. Nice hit. Alright, so as you surround people, their morale starts to waver. So you have different types of morale, and lower morale means that you end up, like you can see here, our eunuch guy is wavering, so he's got negative 10 in melee skill, range skill, all that stuff. And so morale is huge in this game. Damn, he's not hitting anything. Oh my goodness, that just went right past his shield. Oh, damn. Come on, somebody get him. Our eunuch, we gotta help him out. 41%. Alright, let me see if I can hit him. Oh, I hit him again. Wow. Alright. 88% chance. Hoggart is dead. Nicely done. Okay. Alright, let's get everybody down here. Oh, good hit. Wow. That was nice. Alright, we got Hans leveling up here, and we got some... Oh, we got some good loot. Cloth rolls, some bread, some tools. Nicely done. Okay. Alright, Hoggart lies dead in a pool of his own blood. For the company and for all the men who've fallen, let's take this bastard's head back to Kallenberg, yeah. Alright, first things first, we've got patched mail shirt, which is really nice. Really need to give that to our best guy. Honestly, though, I think cultists are really important. But this guy here is pretty good, even though he has -5 melee and ranged. Yeah. Honestly, I'll give it to Hans, because he's our best guy, actually, it seems like. We got an axe, and we also got a falchion. I'll give that to the cultist. And give them the bludgeon. There we go. Now everybody's got a decent weapon. Alright, so leveling up here for Hans. What are we going to make Hans? He's got sure footing. He's got 59 melee. Might make him a shield user. Not exactly sure what I want to do with him, though. He's got 2 in hit points, 1 in resolve, fatigue. Well, we could give him... Yeah, honestly, I have no idea. I think I might just give him student for right now so I can until I can figure out what I want to do with him. I really like the student perk because it gives them plus 20 experience, and then at the end of the 11th level, or when they hit the 11th level, they gain an additional perk point. So we'll give him a student for now. I'm going to increase his health, his fatigue, and plus 3 to melee skills. So that's nice. All right, cool. That's what I'd recommend. If you're not really sure what to do, go student at the beginning. All right, so along the way... See, the battle has left some gear worse for wear and some men a good nick and two. We can patch them up. He's basically saying that if you do make a campfire, then enemies can see you from a distance. So, gotta keep that in mind. But you do repair equipment and heal up a lot faster. All right, so we've returned to Kallenberg. And we've gained 400 crowns, so... Now we're free to do whatever we want. That's kind of like the introduction. If you want to do that quest, you can, or you can bypass it. You had the option to earlier. So, wow, 368 for leather lamellar armor. Anyway. Yeah. All right, so we're going to have to find another contract. Doesn't look like there's any in these two towns. We're going to have to go... Might have to go up here to this port. Wow. This world looks really large. Let's take a look down here. There's a castle. We're not going to get any contracts from any fortifications right now because those belong to the actual factions themselves. And we have to go to some of these outlying towns and villages on the outskirts, like port towns and stuff like that. To get contracts until our company gets known. So right now we are unknown. We don't have enough renown. right now we have 115. We need probably around 3,000 to get known by the other factions. All right, so let's roll up here. It's really crucial at the beginning. You've got to keep an eye on your funds and try not to to waste money. Okay, so we've got a contract here available. Let's see. Brigands killed Wilhelm and his whole family. Can you believe that? I don't know who you are or who they are, but they were well-liked family in these parts. I want these brigands done with. All right, so let's see. What is Grafenhaven prepared to pay for their safety? Okay, so we're going to get 330 crowns when the contract is done. We have a few different options. We can say that we need payment in advance, so that's always good if you're hurting for cash. I always go for we need to be paid more for this. However, sometimes it doesn't work, and it didn't work in this case, so we're just going to accept the offer and accept the contract. There's a training hall here where we can train our men if we want. But we really don't have the money for that at the moment. Let's take a look here. We got some other recruits we can hire. Take a look at their backgrounds. Everybody's got a different background, and some of them have really good stats. Like, some of these guys are really expensive. Like this guy, a raider. So he's going to start off really good. Oh, here's another cultist. I'm going to hire him. There's a messenger. Oh, this guy is badass. Look at this. Melee defense plus 3. Range plus 2. And he's dumb. And he's a brute. Plus 15% damage on a hit to the head. Oh, wow. So we can give him... we can give him Headhunter. If we get him... If he lives that long. However... Oh, melee defense, yeah. And range skill, so I don't know. Maybe he'd be an archer instead. We'll have to see what we're gonna do with him. Alright, anyway. Let's take a look at the market. We're gonna need some food. Damn, they really don't have any food in here. That's cheap. We're gonna have to wait on that. Alright, so we've got to go up here to the north to the worn down fortress. I'm gonna reposition my men here. There we go. Once I find a pole arm, I can put a couple people on the back row. Because pole arms can hit from two spaces. Let's see. We need to pick an ambition, and that's what this is here. You gather your men around, kicking Ewald the eunuch to his feet and telling Kunol to finish scraping away his hairs on his neck later. When their muttering has subsided, you start to address them. What do you tell the men the company will do? So ambitions are kind of goals that you can do. And once you achieve those goals, then you get morale. Like a big morale boost, and sometimes you get other things as well. I'm not going to spoil it yet, but you can get some really cool stuff by completing ambition. So, honestly, the first thing that I like to do is get the company back to a dozen men, because when you have a dozen men, you can afford to lose a couple. And so that's kind of going to be our goal at the beginning. Get ourselves a dozen men, and then we'll be in better shape. Because you can take 12... a dozen men on the in each battle, so we want 12 so that we can take 12. All right, we've got to prepare for combat. Let's engage the enemy, see who they are. Okay, we've got 6 brigands here. Gotta worry about this guy right here, this dude with the axe. All right, we got no archers though, so that's okay. Oh, they are gonna rush. Okay. Let's try and hit this guy. Oh, so close. I'm gonna let them come in. If you take the high ground, it's really important because you actually get a bonus to hit chance if you're in higher ground than your target, or your opponent, rather. I'm gonna let them come to me. Oh, good hit. Good riposte. All right, let's move in, trying to take this guy out. Nice hit. Let's wait and see if they come in. Oh, that could have been bad. Good thing we dodged that. Ouch. All right, so we've got the higher ground. We got a 65% chance there, or a 55. Nice. Damn. So they're gonna avoid me there. I guess we'll go in with Hans there. All right, so let's see. Let's have Erling try and take out this guy. Damn it. Wow, okay, let's go for the Brigand Thug again. Oh, good hit. I don't know if I should go for another swing or not. Let's go with the shield, put the shield up, get better defense. Holy hell, that guy's going right through his shield. Yeah, I think that was a smart decision, because he would have lost his head there, I think. Alright, good job. Okay. Damn. Our crossbowman is not able to hit anybody. Oh, good. Nicely done. Oh, shit. He's out of fatigue. He's got max fatigue. He can't kill that guy. Let's go for it. Oh, he missed. Damn it. Oh, that sucks. This cultist really needs to do some damage. All right, let's go. Let's risk it. Okay, he hit that guy. Nice. Oh. All right, I'm not going to have this guy move in because he's not going to be able to swing from there, so I'll leave him right there. Man, he is fleeing. Oh, he's fleeing. All right, so we don't have to worry about him. All right. Let's go down here and try and help out whoever's down here. Eat that. Oh, nicely done. Good job, guys. There's only one dude left. And he tried to flee and he got killed. So that is really nice. Well done. Look at this. I got some good loot here. Just what we need. I was hoping for some axes or hatchets or something, but that'll work. We'll take what we can get right now. The battle's over, but decisions are still yet to be made. A few brigands survived the battle. Berengar the Insane stands over one, his sword to the prisoner's neck, and he asks you what you wish to do. Slit their throats. You recall how many times brigands slew hapless merchants? The thought is barely out of your mind when you give the order to have the prisoners executed. They pipe up a brief protest, but it is cut short by swords and spears. Okay. Oh, so I don't get their arms or anything? What the hell? Oh, that sucks. I guess I should have went with the other option. Alright, anyway, let's go back to Grafenhaven. We got 330 crowns, and Grafenhaven is no longer has ambush trade routes. So that's good. Everything that you do affects the world. So, for instance, if there's if a town is got missing villagers or something like that, and you solve that issue, then you're going to be able to recruit more villagers here in the town. And same thing with like merchants and stuff like that. So you'll get if you do caravan requests and stuff like that, or contracts to deliver goods to a town, then they're going to be well supplied, so you'll have more things to buy there and stuff like that. So it's pretty cool. Let's go ahead and level up our men here. Alright, let's take a look. This guy has got melee defense, melee skill. Alright, he's going to be our... I guess he's going to be like a two-hander or something like that. So let's go with... it's got melee defense. Let's go plus 4 fatigue, plus 2 health, and plus 2 melee defense. And yeah, he's going to be... probably going to give him like adrenaline or something like that. Yeah, let's give him adrenaline because he's going to be a two-hander. And eventually, we're not going to use two-handed weapons until we have enough armor, because you really have to have some really good armor to even attempt using two-handed weapons early on in the game. And but adrenaline will be really helpful because it puts the character first in the next round's turn order. So that could be really good. All right, Erling the Rock. Let's see, this guy, I have no idea. He's a cultist. No idea what we're going to do with him. I'm just going to make him, I'm going to give him student as well, because I have no idea what to do yet. Let's increase his melee defense. Alright, Torleaf. This guy is going to be another two-hander as well. So, actually, hold on. Let's increase his attack, his melee defense, and let's give him plus 3 fatigue. There we go. And we're going to give him adrenaline as well. All right, the eunuch. Plus 4, plus 2, and plus 3 melee defense. Nice. I'm going to give him student as well. I really love that student skill. It's really awesome at the beginning. Alright, so for our archer, we're going to go plus 4 for ranged. We definitely need that. Oh, plus 3 for melee, though, is really good. I guess we'll go plus 3 ranged defense. Plus 4 on the health. Yeah, plus 4, plus 3, and honestly, I should probably do plus 3 on the melee skill just because that's really good, a good roll for melee, even though plus 4 is nice as well for the health. But he's not really going to use melee that often, so yeah, let's just go with plus 4 on the health for now. And the first perk I'm going to give him is Yeah, I'm just gonna give him student. Because the next skill I'm gonna give him is bullseye. Could give him a short bow. And then, yeah. All right, anyway, that works for right now. That really does work. And we're not gonna find anything in this town, so we have to go to another town. Let's go over here to, oh, wait, we're not gonna be able to get anything there. We're gonna have to go back to somewhere. Yeah, we gotta go to this town over here. Schweikhof. And the company will travel roads as much as they can, but once they need to, then they gotta go through different terrain. And as you go through different terrain, you kinda slow down. Going through mountains, obviously, is the slowest travel speed. Okay, we got a contract here, and let's see. They've spent the past few days hunting for missing folks that seem disappearing to the gods know where. Anyway, they've got missing people. People are being taken. Horrible beasts are afoot, sellsword, and I need you to go after them. Okay, what's this worth to you? 320, he says. We need to be paid more. Okay, so we're going to get 330. All right, I accept. Okay, so there's missing villagers. Oh, there's a weaponsmith here. Oh, we're almost out of food, too. All right, let's buy these ground grains. They're only 66. It's a little high for grains, but we'll have to do it. Not bad. Can get rid of these bucklers. And a couple other things here. Don't need this crap. We got 790 coin, not bad. 21 tools and supplies. We're doing pretty good so far. So we just gotta keep this up. Got a couple miners here we could hire if we wanted. But we'll have to see what we're gonna do next time, and we're gonna get into, we've gotta track these, follow these footprints and find the beasts. And engage them, but we'll get into that next time, guys. Hope you enjoyed a little first look at Battle Brothers and a first look at this series as we continue on. This is going to be a lot of fun doing this Iron Man, and once we lose this, we're going to move into probably expert difficulty and give that another try and see how far we get. If we only get 5 days in or 10 days, I don't know. It'll be cool to watch and see and follow along. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode, and if you want to see more, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys again next time. Take care.